Your data logger needs a program to read sensors, store data, and do control. You will be using Shortcut to generate a simple program. Select Create Program via Shortcut from the row of icons at the top of the PC400 window. The program generator opens. Select Create New Program. Select the data logger model that you are writing the program for. Choose the CR350. Click Next. The first time you run Shortcut, you're prompted for the first notch frequency. Choose 50 Hz for most of the world, 60 Hz if you're in North America and parts of South America. After that, all programs will use that setting. You can check or change it later from the program menu. Likewise, the first time you run Shortcut, you are asked to select which group of sensor files will be displayed when creating a program. Campbell Scientific Incorporated, US, or Campbell Scientific Limited, UK. This, like the frequency notch, can be changed later through the program menu. By default, the data logger battery voltage and processing board temperature are measured. It is good practice to keep these measurements to monitor the health of the data logger. Add a thermocouple measurement next. Type thermocouple in the search box. You are using a Type T thermocouple in this example, so select that here. One of these is shipped with every data logger. If you do not have one, you can use another sensor you do have. Add it to the sensor list by double-clicking or clicking this arrow. A new window with the thermocouple properties will open. Use the default settings. If you wanted to change the name of the variable that stores the temperature measurement, you could change that here. Thermocouples require a reference temperature. For this tutorial, you will be using the CR350 processing board temperature, PTEMP-C, as your reference. Click the wiring tab to see how the thermocouple is wired to the CR350. The wiring diagram shows how to attach the thermocouple to the data logger. Disconnect power from the data logger by disconnecting the USB cable and insert the wires as shown in the diagram. Use a flat blade screwdriver to secure each wire, making sure the terminal closes on the wire, not the wire insulation. Incorrect wiring, or not following the diagram provided, is a common new user error. Click OK to continue. At this time, you can add additional sensors in the same way. When you're finished, remember to plug the USB cable back into the CR350. Click Next. This is the output setup to specify the data you want stored and later copied to your computer. This is the information that you need to do your job, one of the reasons you have a data logger. First, set how often you want the CR350 to take measurements. For this tutorial, set the scan interval to 1 second. Enter a name for the first table. The name needs to start with a letter and has to be 20 characters or less. Name the table 1min. In this example, you want to store data once each minute, or every 60 seconds. Since the interval is 60, choose seconds as the units. Or you can change the interval to 1 and use minutes. Select Table 2. Rename this table Daily. The duration of 1,440 minutes is equal to 1 day. Leave this duration as is for the daily record. If you prefer, you can change this duration to 24 hours or 1 day. Click Next. Now it's time to add measurements with processing to the tables. Have the data logger store the average air temperature each minute. Since the data logger is taking 1 second measurements, this will be an average of 60 discrete measurements. Other measurements and processing are added in the same way. It is a good idea to store the minimum battery voltage. With the maximum and minimum outputs, you can also store the time the maximum or minimum occurred. In this example, it would be which second in the 60 was the minimum. You are not going to store the time. A sample records the latest measured value without any special processing. Other tables or output intervals are set up in a similar way. When you are done configuring the output, click Finish and save your program. By default, the program is named Untitled. It is a good idea to give the program a descriptive name. Let's call this program sctest.scw. The program is checked for any errors or warnings. And if you have established communications to the data logger, you can send the program now. We won't send the program yet. It is a good habit to collect the data from your CR350 before sending a new program. You can do that through the Connect screen, where you will also send the program. Select No and send the program later. Shortcut provides a summary showing the sensor wiring and program tables. And under the Advanced tab, you will see the CR Basic program. If you need to go back to your program in the future to make changes, you can. When you're done, close Shortcut. Now that you have your program generated, you will go back to PC400 and send the program to your CR350 and begin collecting data.